What?
Shouldn't you?
Yeah, they have like a counter plan and like a PA.
I know, I'm the worst kind of person, I'm sorry.
You're busy coaching Westminster debate?
Yeah, you know, the Pinecrest round robin is coming up. Put in those late hours.
Did you just replace the Westminster?
I think so, maybe. Nice. Either you or Sigalos, it depends on. Yeah, I mean, fairly interchangeable.
I meant just connecting. Alright, yeah. The 182 is set.
Could I have paper? Sorry.
Yes.
Again, we're scouters.
Like, essentially, we're kept perfectly. Like, this person who's floating on paper is in front of the mic. So there's no, like, technical.
Oh, that's true. Ultimately, that's what.
That's pretty good. The United States federal government should implement the Clean Power Plan using a mass-based emission standards that do not count biomass as carbon neutral on the basis that the Clean Power Plan is a non-coercive use of federal spending power that is deserving of deference and vantage point as tech. The CPP restructures the energy market as key tech industry, sustainability, reliable data centers, and cloud computing tech. And 16, cloud computing process services, mapping possible cloud electricity. This is used to carbon manufacturing facilities, logistics operations, stores, and large data centers. These make modern computing work. The accelerating transition to a low carbon economy will produce multiple benefits, less pollution, possibly longer term certainty and prices comparable to other options. CPP will advance purposes of low level renewable electricity compliment by the public system. Market trends, cheap local time, found to the economic and sustainable plan. In a place where the renewable electricity industry will continue with electricity sellers as more reasons to work with significant purchasers, the CPP will help tech companies build their power operations always consistent with their businesses. Tech is the most energy intensive sector by far. Major efficiency gains, reliable clean energy, and new energy business models are necessary to meet demand and lock in growth. It's key to internet, IoT, cloud computing, electronics, and next-gen semiconductors, bills, and love the high tech problems required without software energy. If you think about energy intensive as chips, you can manage to look at in square miles when annualizing you advertise for time to public cloud that pays more than 10% of the annual uses is an operational challenge. Your efficiency gains are processing what creates more demand in cloud. The appetite of microprocessors, threefold storage is cheaper per byte. The are a long way from saturation writing, which doesn't have the energy efficiency of processing per 10-20-fold, a whole lot more man shaped that build electricity increase efficiency with driving more time. The internet is not looking for internet 2.0 power. You just want to try to volume blow as a constellation of overload from the service ring, converge between the old kind of electrical infrastructure and the new kind of digital infrastructure is allowed for the rest of the world. Later, we find next generation semiconductors using gallium nitride demand of the data center production is picking up virtual sessions for a maximum initial heart rate. 95% experience at least a long time. Averages tell us how many explosion promises to create a new gorgeous electricity to meet intensity. The new appetite of cloud is a problem. Other cities evidence that the new global tech movement that actually that all the components are aligned for enormous growth. The Internet of Things innovation is essential to healthcare, improves surveillance, reduces drug reactions, and prevents disease. Versus, and 15, the IoT holds credentials to over patient safety devices that ensure caregivers can use to watch while the forensic team and test with the procedure to prevent infection, social drug evidence, and continue quality care. The IoT is helping hospitals avoid mitigating prevent adverse events and drug safety. The IoT can allow for real time estimate vitals and results and pan together data that are helping researchers develop strategies to boost surveillance and implement something as simple as connected hygiene monitoring to reduce the infection providers may be able to cut their severe infection rates without breaking the infection rates without breaking the bank guarantees and homes and power to foster more frequent data information of the things we have hospitalizations. The IoT based data innovations are the only hope to solve antibiotic resistance disease threats. Gene 16, the data science can play a central role in the fight against the looming global threats. The big challenge is creating software can make all the data useful and bound our AMR overuse of antibiotics and humans. One of the biggest AMR risk registered in their possession is critically important. Almost everyone everywhere in the world, physicians routinely prescribe antibiotics. We need the world's top pharmaceutical efforts to encourage the stewardship of current currently available therapies hastening to start moving under. Take measures to prevent us from slipping into a post-antibiotic era. Achieving these goals will be all but impossible without lots of data. Data science can provide new anti-miracle medicines to you overuse of ones we already have and reshape health systems in Japan. Turbocharge efforts to find and implement solutions. Antibiotic resistance causes extinction. Gutman 15, the overposition of antibiotics has created a public health menace. This has led to superbugs and mutant powerful bot spectrum treatments and patients will be thrust back into time before we had any drugs. If we were to defuse the drug bug bomb, we need to limit the current use of drugs and new antibiotics. Commercial action is focused on the impending public health crisis. It's possible to take various actions like perimeter stewardship for antibiotics to be dropped or hit antibiotic resistance infections and natural colonies against the maintenance and outbreak would lead to a catastrophic result. Antibiotic resistance infections have become a problem with the trying to show that it represents a threat to the nation's security. Extinction grows out to the world live with the world live with the concept spectrum of nuclear war. The end of the Cold War to the potency of the armed and existential dangers have multiplied. The biggest problems are biology, the influence of this case, and for the ancient animal caught us with all of our pants on the virus under the deadly S1918. The result would have rivaled nuclear war, would have been a total disaster. Society would fall apart. CPP is key to energy efficiency. Consent D50 with the CPP. The states and businesses are trying to plan how they will comply. Energy efficiency will be a key component. States utilities will increase investment efficiency. We realize the reverse program saving residential and business consumers. Money efficiency also promotes substantial benefits. States plans will not only rely on energy efficiency, not only its cost effective, but it also produces economic benefits. The increase in energy efficiency investment will open the industry. The EPA stimulates savings and insurance by giving states an opportunity to redeem credits through EE solves the sanction. Moving to 13 energy conservation is critical to me has been growing. Aside from the problems with the pollution, the cost is enormous. Emission sources are unconventional. Energy prices are growing and becoming volatile. The consumption brings environmental dangers. The government agrees to allow the air conditioning system to destroy the ozone layer. Russia depletes the fields, but also spectrum of resources. Only a small fraction can be replaced in enough to work out. The pollution has affected a large part of community. The potential risk greater than climate and terrorism, pollution, disaster, including war and pandemic diseases. To avoid this, we need a bridge. The only possible is energy conservation, which will allow us to sustain our functions. Advantage to is courts, status quo, environmental federalism laws, indeterminate, a lack of a clear model leads to erratic and escalating coercion based challenges. Buzzby in 1680. Regulatory interest in use of federalism to shrink federal regulatory power out there is involving corporate federalism structures as well as like preemption claims. These arguments produce erratic results in problem and indeterminacy for raised federalism. Allocations of power leave room for environmental progress through the latitude for innovation, self led law, and fence learning and influence alignment and regulatory federalism. First, administrative laws have been blurred as the locus of new federalism disputes to sharp developments emerged from the HIV by a syllabus. The clear majority also held that the spending was unconstitutionally coercive. The law spending was unconstitutionally coercive. The syllabus contains language of federalism and limited power that's already being used to budgets. Trust that people grounds protect the claims of overreach remain prominent. Claims were central to efforts to preclude any restoration of federal authority via new legislation to write the limits of success. It's not becoming vacant itself and some challenges, even though cases federalism room documents sometimes garnered substantial support. The results have been erratic to the internal development is hindered due to the court's failure to reconcile clashing cases. A little certain about the realm of regulatory corruption, anti regulatory agencies have to expand the reach is often unchanged federal statutes. The CPP is the nexus of environmental federalism disputes, failure to address coercive challenges, and undermines EPA sanctioning authority. Ever than 17, there's nothing unusual about requiring firms to offset the emissions with greater reductions. The CEA sanctions imposed as a means of preparing states to cooperate with persons would appear to break down constitutional portion of conditions that the court would allow. A law that threatens states with lower speed limits is serious, but now the CEA deposed the potential preventing states with the offer they cannot refuse in the spending causes, leveraging their reliance on federal funds, assessed by their reasons, suspected buildings, leveraging the captives of preemption for holding money for unrelated programs, those coercion, the expressive position for importance in not cooperating states, maybe as well. The NFP coerced their arguments for serve future prematurely attacks on the CDP. The EPA hopes that states will use the SAPs to encourage conservation and efficiency. The ultimate level is greater than can be achieved by merely imposing controls. 27 states filed suit. The states argue that the CDP is coercive because it forces states to participate. The CDP was an excessive range of reduction requirements. The stakes involved in the CDP may be higher than the NFP in peril portions of the CEA. The majority appears to undermine the CEA sanctions, which seems the course willingness to find coercion opens the door to coercion arguments and the facility challenges to the CEA is offset Britain to perhaps the CDP. The course willingness to accept coercion against the use of additional spending creates opportunities to alter the entire landscape of the doctrine. Even if they don't always succeed, anti-environmental arguments spill over without clear resolution. Brand 16, the anti-coercion argument will classify unconstitutional law. Any federal state reductions of emissions, even authorized by the legislation, civil radical suppressment, and now Congress authority to regulate these specifics of the revenue rules will hardly matter. It's difficult to mention any policy designed to specifically reduce the emissions that will not entail fundamental changes. The political actors make constitutional arguments, whether their argument ultimately succeed in the court is not the question. Officials act upon their own judgments long before their actions are tested in court. This would not prevent the states from refusing to cooperate with the EPA and addressing the environmental problem. It destroys the CAA and EPA authority to regulate landfills and sulfur long term. The 15th and 11th, we've largely eviscerated the EPA and new private authorities regulating the future emissions of dangerous air pollutants, such as carbon dioxide, methane, landfill gas, and total reduced sulfur. The Murray's theory would have the confidence of mentally eviscerate system one level, the virtually every additional source category is already listed in minimum such to merge, but I mentioned somewhere in the legislative history, Murray's interpretation would be consistent with the fact that overthrow the act structure and design Congress did not deviate from the act's single theme, comprehensive production, and definitely opening up the gaping loophole through which dangerous pollutants could escape extinction. Long stroke in 15, the CPP addresses urgent environmental challenges. The rule will secure critical important reductions in carbon dioxide and the efforts to include rising sea levels, a good flow close to population centers, frequent intense weather events, impaired air and water quality, shrinking water supplies, and threatened infectious diseases, species extinction, national security threats. The emissions reduction strategy are not only already widely used, but also have been incorporated into newer CA regulatory programs. Petitioners seek to support any federal limitation of the power plant's CO2 emissions, or at least to limit the scope to negligible requirements. It would fail to address the threats presented. Petitioners champion the statutory constructions that are not required by the statutory text. CPP enforcement is key to waste energy projects. One of these, specifically Harway in 16, the MSPS and emissions guidelines radically lower the threshold which the landfill must install controls to lower emissions, creating an opportunity for landfill and industry to gas energy products and generating common credits under federal and emissions trading programs. Control options include routing gas to non-enclosed flare and systems that process the clean gas for beneficial use. The latter options offer the industry benefit of existing programs to biogas off GE as broadly recognized as a renewable energy source. Power protection program and alternative fuel projects may field opportunities in emerging CPV for public EPA 6 to 5 energy. Technology progress provide resources. The EUA or GE has commented the CEA will have to consider to increase the stringency of the standards for existing sources, but the inclusion of optional method of the EPA to the rules will solve. That's an increase in methane capture for new and existing landfill operations. This includes the landfill gas energy products and regulations create the opportunities for landfill owners to play more productive roles. Key to future microgrids run in 16. The waste combustion plants are more efficient energy generation. Disposal should reduce the waste by 90% of the generation storage and demand for management reside at the core of the smart process for generation. Enhances energy efficiency, electricity generation. EFW is supposed to advocate more deferable generation patterns. Integration was investigated. Many of them have been duration. The EW 5 plants work as backup generation operating case in excessive demand and microgrid in case of excessive peak demand. It's key to military microgrid solves escalating vulnerabilities while keys in 17 outages are growing in security. Weather 187% the number reflects the growing vulnerability of the nation grid. The utilities are experiencing an increase in major data events in addition to the hazards of critical vulnerable threats both from the cyber defense going through the cyber attacks. Hackers can manipulate the systems are fulfilling the return of warning signals and both vital information. It's only a matter of when, not if, you're going to see group and grade some destructive behavior. Defense installations will require reliable power and tactical systems and data are piloted from U.S. bases. Many have enhanced intelligence surveillance capability that support critical missions. Bases from high value R&D. Marks at these evidence that R&D solves global conflicts down in 15. The only thing that keeps the peace is deterrence. If we live in a violent world, readiness can keep the peace with the adversary. Not to calculate the consequences of confrontation must be credible and tangible. The deterrence from a great power war, the counter that deals with millions. The military power war would involve a whole new group of states to condense civilization posture that leaves back your adversaries down in the U.S. resolve to resolve and readiness calculation is inhumane. America's most important role has been to dampen the great powers. This has been deepened on, has depended on America's military might. There holds no better recipe for great power peace.
Good.
Yeah.
What military threats are there currently that require readiness?
Yeah, so our piece of borrowed evidence and the piece of evidence before that speaks to threats to the grid as one example. So cyber attacks are one
why
form
is
of military,
military
threat.
Readiness key to check cyber attacks?
And then our Marquis evidence says that the military is kind of forward deployed in a bunch of places in Asia and the Middle East, etc., where we have to be able to maintain stable forward presence.
Stable forward presence.
So
what
I think
the grids in the United States have to do with stable forward presence in places in Asia and the Middle East.
Well, we've read an internal link that talks about the way that the military shares intelligence abroad and has the ability to maintain stable communication, command and control, etc.
About the grid's impact, how does military readiness deal with cyber attacks?
Well, we've made an argument about how the app improves the stability and the resiliency
of the
grid.
So it's just about the resiliency of the grid for that internal link.
Yeah.
Okay, cool. Diseases, which ones, how do they escalate? How do they affect the body?
So our evidence in particular speaks to antibiotic resistance. I think some of the diseases that it cites are influenza pandemic, it cites H1N1, and it speaks to the idea that antibiotic resistant infections.
So H1N1, how does that evolve to kill the entire world considering it didn't really do anything?
Well, so our evidence says that there are more dangerous strains. It cites the 1918 bird flu as an example of one. It says
so
that when
1918 bird flu is an example,
yeah,
of a global
one that
pandemic
was much,
that will cause extinction.
One that was much more deadly. The world is now much more globalized, and we've read evidence that says that antibiotic resistance has grown significantly since then.
What companies does the app incentivize with new tech?
What do you mean?
Evidence just says CPP is key to give companies tech and investment. What companies are those?
So some of the examples cited, I believe, are companies like Amazon and Google who need to maintain very large data servers and to have renewable energy rules that they need to meet.
So Amazon and Google, cool. I guess, why are Amazon and Google necessary to create new responses to disease?
Well, so I think our argument is more about development of the Internet of Things and broader technology
what
structures.
What is the Internet of Things?
So, I don't know, do you want to define the Internet of Things?
So the Internet of Things is kind of the concept of having a large number of interconnected devices that are able to kind of speak to each other.
I guess, who controls the data that is necessary that these companies need to develop new antibiotics, etc.?
Well, obviously, that data is partially controlled by the commercial market. I'm sure some of it
partially
will also be controlled by the government.
So
like,
government
data to develop the Internet of Things is partially commercialized.
So does the app give more information
to
companies like Google and Amazon?
Well, the app provides the commercial incentive to better develop tech.
Okay, cool. That's all.
Can I merge it?
Yeah.
I already sent out the 1AC, but
here, just
2AC.
Yeah, 2AC.
The order is 3 off, and then the case in the 1AC order.
Here.
good. Great. The tax reform GOP is unified now, which is critical to ensure it's Bolton Cusack. 131 seconds ago, the unity of the entire GNC and the GOP conference appears to be on the same page along the lines of Marines uncertain. McConnell preserved his GOP majority. Most Democrats are not interested in working with the GOP to overhaul. The next Republicans are looking to pass those on party line votes on their special bunch checkers to protect them. Reveal a bunch of GOP better. All your people line up. They have a limited amount of time to enact major legislation and issue such a comprehensive tax reform. The plan spurs backlash. Fox News supporting Obama to give me the coal industry by mandating cutting carbon emissions. The controversial regulations that lawmakers are trying to block the coal industry and coal sale lawmakers were immediately wary. Rahul announced we will introduce bipartisan legislation that will prevent these from wreaking havoc on our economy. McConnell called it a dagger in the heart of the middle class. Obama circumventing Congress. Hundreds of coal plants will have to comply, which has resulted in strong opposition from energy business. And coal state Democrats, Republicans, governors of Kansas, Kentucky, Virginia, and West Virginia have already signed laws directing the environmental agency to develop their own carbon emissions plan. The plan wrecks unity. The margin for error is very thin. Searcher in 16th large Republican state unified, they will be able to advance conservative priorities. The danger they could choose a losing battle or winning one whose victory comes into high price. Democrats, other governing majorities vanish. After Bruce fights passed out, their one false step could lead to ruin. Trump turned heads when he sat down with Al Gore to discuss climate change and global environmental issues. Embrace the liberal position. You can jeopardize the Republican backing car because this investment party will be hard pressed to attract much love from the political left. Tax reform is key to fast growth. It sustains hegemony more. 11-15 fast growth. The economy is imperative for America to retain our world super fast, especially given the new right wing fast growing China. This requires the new Trump plan biggest pro growth tactics is Reagan energy policy to develop abundant research matter in America. First pro business approach. Economics client causes war that escalates the WMDU's January 14. It can happen again. The anniversary has put a spotlight on the fragility of world's political and economic security system. Given the fragility, choice of control might make war easily. Winnable dynamics now re-emerging. The threat of disruption generates a new sort of uncertainty. One that mirrors 1914. At that time, no one could really know whether the clashes would escalate. The strategic doctrine of MAB would mutually assure destruction, left no doubt that a superpower conflict would inevitably escalate. Disruption raised the prospect that others might mount the same sort of operation. There is an enhanced temptation to roll the dice, even though the game may be fatal. Next up is the K. Political solutions to warming are cruel, optimistic investments in fear to motivate action and a mode of training ground to integrate the warming threat into another far-off scenario to lull the population into productivity. Not only does this naturalize the most violent and racialized state terrorism and genocide, it also eviscerates the value of existence as our lives become feedback loops of dashed hopes met with economic anxiety. The alternative is to take the position of the philosopher who interrupts the absorption of the resonances of fear that grease the wheels of modern power, Scranton in 15. Different visions of the human future are already hardening into conflict. Government proximity, the willingness to use military force to defend themselves and advance their interests spectacularly. Obviously, we're waiting by the New Jersey government says no people are taking the outright support of the shell and shepherd is another example. You've heard the call. We have to do something. We need to fight, identify the enemy, and go after the rich, take shelter in their fortress of the threat of death. Activates our deepest animal drive, carefully manage it, channel outbreaks of panic and hatred, reach for lower levels of aggression and fear, help keep a population control. Both productive people in the United States have been subject to an unprecedented terror campaign, national domestic policy transform, security, the cost of fear, torture, SWAT tanks, and total surveillance, in which white black is the definitive semiotic distinction, structuring American society violence, is directed against those darkest and fear. Well, it comes to us every day in our constant compass and weather porn, unpredictable shifts, informally stable climate dynamics, and massive storms. Somebody killed somebody, guns, crimes, immigrants, terrorists, Arabs, Mexicans. People will do almost anything to avoid being afraid. We let the fear short circuit our own autonomous desires, diverting us from our old goals and loading ever more emotional static into our daily cognitive processing. We reinforce patterns of thought and feeling the chip of society that breeds the same capitalism and cultural machinery for balancing fear and aggression is grinding and sputtering, sparks the cruel optimism of systems sustained by hopes that can never be fulfilled because dangerously advanced for anxiety or fear and aggression be channeled into labor consumption, economic competition. Once the social fabric begins here, unleashing not only riot and rebellion and civil war, but homicidal politics, the likes of which should make our blood run cold. Iraq has been blighted for decades by imperial aggression, criminal gangs apart. Between a corrupt autocracy, Syria has been suffering water shortages that left more than 800,000 Syrians without a livelihood. This drought is part of a long-term warming and drying trends that are transforming the Middle East. You can draw very credible climate connection to this disaster. We call ice right now while the world burns. The United States has been playing chicken with Russia and with China. This is our present and future war for oil, water, gas, and food politics. The energetic distribution of bodies consists of our political and social media technologies are not neutral, but have been developed to serve particular interests. Second, with every protest, channel, retweet, and Facebook post, we stronger resonators and weaker thinkers. Third, social vibrations remain locked within machinery that offers no political leverage. They do not translate to political action because they do not connect the flows of power. Finally, global warming offers no apprehensible flow. We can live constantly collecting fields of excitation. A subject can be an interrupter if it fails it often and usually does. The interrupter is integrated, driven mad, ignored, and destroyed, responding freely to the ongoing alarms of war, environmental catastrophe, and global destruction demands a reorientation of the feelings that every new impulse is held at a distance until it fades or can be changed. Next off is the counter. The United States Supreme Court, citing United States v. Lopez, should rule that the federal government lacks authorization in the Commerce Clause to mandate state participation in environmental regulatory schemes and devolve authority over determining the best system of emission reductions outside of source level requirements to the states. The 50 state governments and all relevant sub-federal entities should, through an independent agency supporting uniform implementation, implement the Clean Power Plan using mass-based emissions targets that do not count biomass as carbon neutral. Unfunded EPA mandates have collapsed divisions of power. The counterplan repudiates them, which establishes a clear signal for federalism. Rifkin et al. 15, the rationale of NFIB applies equally to attempts at Commerce Clause reg. Has crossed line and leverages this national tenet. The key to modifying the EPA's building block approach is the best system of emission reduction the agency finds to include any measure to improve emissions rate the agency. Use anything related to sources fair game for regs that apply to the source alone. EPA's best system of emission reduction, not only the best reading of the term A, federal report would read the term emission reduction becomes only source level measures and have to vacate EPA's action is contrary to law. The best that can be said of the CPP is that it will provide a valuable opportunity for the courts to advance federalism when they strike it down. Federalism is key to water management, creating a level of prospect of nationalization.
to water resources should give pause water shift local. These things need to be sacrificed. Water transportation national scale will be incredibly expensive. The balance of authority and water management will depend on proper governmental rules. We are likely to end up with optimal balanced water fields. Please start sooner rather than later. That decimates the U.S. agriculture sector, WEF. 11 of the agriculture sectors is dependent upon the water sector for clean irrigation and processed water. Agriculture accounts for 80% of the nation's consumption of water use throughout the production process and distribution. The food supply water use is a central major user of water as livestock water in the extinction. Clearing 12 rising food prices lead to widespread social risk. Buying coffee food is essential to human survival. Many nations depend on the U.S. to supplement their harvest. What happened to the U.S. supplies has an immense impact around the world as crops disappear. The price of all grains soar. Surging prices result in widespread social unrest. The analysts are worried. Warning instability in Africa and China higher food prices could lead to these flooding of the global economy. Efforts including food rights, mass starvation effects, including food rights, mass starvation, state collapse, mass migrations, and full-scale war could prove deadly. Hunger wars will fill our future. The tech advantage. The F doesn't solve a litany of all causes of Mazarov and 13 technical infrastructure and geopolitical surveillance, consumerism, and surveillance into reality. But the increasing internet control are interconnected ways in which most of us would rather not acknowledge the way we do. Communicating today is broken for political and economic reasons. Governments have surrendered communication networks and technology. Companies introducing tech checks, building more privacy, or making state demands. Tech companies can create the impression that something is being done. We might be living through a transformation in how capitalism works with data. Emerging an alternative payment regime that costs the citizens or democracy and might create stronger intermediaries to indulge data obsession. The surveillance debate must be linked to debates about capitalism. We should not allow preemption to crowd out systemic attempts to pinpoint the problems. These issues are not today's agenda. Many of us have wanted this simplistic narrative that we just need more laws, more tools, no transparency, more transparency, no pandemic impact, really 12 apes, let's think that other viruses would wreak revenge. HIV was the only new tropical virus to go by, never starts to live in quarantines amid predictions of Armageddon, killing just 774. Bird flu was 200 new global pandemic, is glowing a suck opportunity to jump to the human species has not risen despite the media hype. Infections are thriving, but only by being mild. The ability of medical science to sequence this genome and cure is getting better. Public health is fine now. Younger men and eight, the world's becoming better. Equipped surveillance, communication, genetic analysis, vaccine protection, antibiotics, preventing WHO teams encourage quarantines and treatments denied the opportunity to create a super path. Our impact is hype, tetra and 13. There are three weapons, first are bacteriophages. There have been researched in phages of combat resistance, but today's research focuses on genetically developing strains. Second is bacteriophages, since their function was so impressive that they were tested in their natural state. They showed broad spectrum bacteria. Third, peptides killed not only bacteria, but also fungal and viral infection when post-antibiotic era was first mentioned. The attitude was fear. However, with alternatives, the future looks much brighter. The plan escalates. CPP doesn't solve the environment impact from 1 to 15. It seeks to cut power sector emissions 30% from 2005 goals. The ongoing transformation of the U.S. grid to shift from coal to gas and renewables plus heating electricity demand has already gotten us halfway to that goal, and the plan hasn't even taken effect yet. The draft rules won't do much to coal generation. The states with the deepest addiction to coal have some of the weakest targets for reducing their emissions. Kentucky will only have to cut its emissions 80%. It's already retiring so many coal pollutants. State officials doubt they'll need to shut down anymore. The EPA came up with similarly modest targets for coal-rich states like West Virginia, Wyoming, and Indiana. The court's advantage. Status quo federalist model solves smart grid innovation, and the plan reverses that. Elson and 13 First Response finesse the question about whether the regulatory adoption necessary to ensure this market standardized for decision may have been the best. Silence is indeed golden. FERC has recognized that adoption will be unnecessary for interoperability. Government agencies are composed of public service, not market participants. Describe this as an attempt, an inherent danger of bureaucracy when it attempts to regulate a fast-moving area of commerce. States has a layer of complexity. FERC will fix serious challenges. FERC is now able to play a more ideal role in a vibrant federal system. Federal government is best when it's brokers and collaborations in which participants work together. It's a creative and dynamic approach that we might think of as government-led crowdsourcing. Mark that card. Many Trumpy all causes to military readiness. Call 131. Trump's grand strategy is not the tradition of American foreign policy, posing an acute threat to the liberal national order that is underwritten U.S. security played by international tension. By internal tension levels that will make it difficult to achieve objectives. First, it will be difficult for Trump to reconcile his policies toward Iran, toward Russia and Iran, with his desire to defeat the Islamic State, desire to go all in. Putin is likely to backfire. This is a recipe for fueling civil war. Trump's executive order is banning refugees, making it much less likely the Muslim countries will step up their support for the U.S. fight. Trump's approach to Europe and Russia is equally self-defeating. Embrace of Putin will also embolden Moscow's attempts to divide and coerce its European neighbors. Trump's likely to have difficulty taking action against China while contending with the growing threat from North Korea. Trump's tendency to dismiss America's key allies, Japan and South Korea will further complicate efforts to address North Korea, ceding the economic battlefield to Beijing, undermining America's geopolitical position in the world's most dynamic region. The Asia Pacific views the TPP as about whether U.S. geopolitical member states are likely to make a decision based on perception of retrenchment by Trump. What guarantee do they have that the Trump administration will actually show up in a major security threat emerging? Trump's proposal to build a wall could create a train wreck in the U.S.-Mexico relationship. I don't know if time to read another card, but he'll roll back on the air. He said he would.
The internal link is GOP unity. It was written on the 7th of December. Since then, there have been fights over the ACA, over tax reform itself, over court nominations. Why didn't any of that destroy the GOP enough to trigger the link?
Well, so our Bolton evidence is much more recent than that. It's from January 31st and indicates that the Senate GOP legislatively speaking.
No, so
even
I understand.
If there are some divisions.
No,
then,
yeah,
like,
but hold on, let's just take a step back for a second. I understand they're still unified, but my question is why that's the case despite fights over other things.
Well, so I think there's a distinction between, like, how Republicans perceive Trump's political agenda and how they perceive, like, you know, his popularity.
Okay, so let's talk about that. So is your argument that the GOP is fractured because some people want the plan and some people don't, or because they fight with Trump?
Our argument is that the plan is a liberal concession that fractures GOP unity.
Why?
So
if they all don't want it.
What do you mean?
Like, your evidence says the GOP hates stuff that's anti-coal. That's, like, the whole GOP.
Yeah,
they
well,
all
Trump would have to pass the plan. The plan text says you
okay,
have
so which goes back to my
have to sign the
original,
plan or veto
hold
override.
On. That goes back to my original question, though, which is whether the GOP disunity is with the, is among, like, senators and congresspeople within the GOP, or whether the GOP unity is between the president and senators and congresspeople.
I mean, I don't know why those two are distinct. Our argument
they're
is
very
that,
different.
Right, so our argument is that there are senators from West Virginia, Kentucky, our evidence cites a couple more examples that are in line with Trump's policy in the status quo that the plan causes them to shift away. So I guess to answer your question simply, it's GOP unity between Trump and the Senate.
Okay, so then my question is, if the AF causes the Senate to get mad at Trump, but right now the Senate is trying to convince Trump to pass their version of tax reform, why does them getting mad at Trump mean they no longer try to convince Trump to do something that they want?
Well, so our argument is that they're on the same page in terms of tax reform right now. It's not that the Senate is trying to convince Trump of
okay.
any kind of certain
we can have a debate about that. Fair enough.
Yeah.
Is this in a benefit to the counterplan?
Yeah.
Okay, the piece of internal link evidence to this add-on is from Craig. He says that nationalization of water resources should give us pause. Why does the AF cause nationalization of water?
Well, I don't know if it causes nationalization of water, but it's about the balance of authority in terms of allocation. It says that a federal model or like a more centralized model cannot effectively manage and distribute water. So
I understand, but there's kind of a difference between like total nationalization of water resources.
Yeah, well, I mean,
the
first,
federalism
the language
model
you're reading
the
there
hold
says...
On. And the federalism sure. model of the AF, and my question is where Craig speaks to the type of model that our case is about.
I mean, obviously, Craig doesn't talk about
okay,
the
so why
the line you're citing says... That said, however, the prospect of whole-scale
nationalization, yeah,
whole-scale and,
nationalization.
And federalization
right.
of water
why does the
resources?
Plan cause either of those things?
Well, because, well, I mean, that's the Rifkin argument is that the EPA is doing that in the status quo
right.
because of those demands of the plan, or the counterplan, I should say.
What do you expect?
Do you go to a lot of high school tournaments?
Not really. I mean, I've gone to like four, I think. I'm going to three more.
Three more? Every three high school tournaments left?
What?
Oh, NBCA and TOC.
Yeah. And then Pinecrest, the Prestige. I hear a lot of good things about it, I guess.
I've heard that the Pinecrest tournament is amazing. I've heard it's like debate vacation.
Yeah.
I've heard that there's shrimp cocktail in the Judge's Lounge.
Yeah, really the draw is like Seth's there,
yeah.
So.
Yeah.
True.
What's your email?
I don't think I can judge.
High school debates?
Yeah, like I can barely judge a middle school debate.
Honestly, high school debate, you don't really have to pay attention to the last two rebuttals, and even then you really just don't have to pay attention.
No, but then like if people said like if old people said that about college debate, like that would make me sad. So I just like feel kind of bad.
They're also angsty teenagers, so they don't really care anything.
That's true.
Like, I think I told a kid I didn't care about their feelings once because I was in the middle of doing chemistry homework and they just kind of laughed and walked away.
It's definitely like deciding who dropped the least a lot of the time, and yeah.
Yeah.
That's definitely.
Kind of just not wanting to like cry yourself to sleep. It's like
It doesn't get that intense for me because I don't.
I only judge Bojo debates now.
Oh well, that one.
So
okay, yeah.
Yeah. And they're
so
all
hearing
just
the same
terrible
blocks over and over again. Yep.
Oh, okay. Not even blocks, just like random KM rants that aren't good.
Amusing to say.
Advantage one, advantage two. Counterplan, politics, and hate.
Sorry. What?
Tech, sports, counterplan, politics.
More Zach is about globalized internet exchanges and things like surveillance. It doesn't respond to our internal language, which is about tech diffusion and the ability of health systems to communicate with each other, which they are already able to do, which is what our impact talks about when it says that the CDC is able to talk to other countries. Yes, pandemics, antibiotic diseases take out all of their defense. The app is key to public health systems and investments in new infrastructure. That's the only way to solve, because there needs to be proper antibiotic management. Otherwise, the proper pills do not get distributed properly, and we don't get the things that can actually circumvent diseases. The health system is not fine. This evidence is far too old, and it's disproven by something like Ebola. Their next piece of evidence is talks about new medications being needed. The app is key to that because there isn't a proper investment or management incentive to do it right now. The energy efficiency out on their card just says that states have an incentive to keep doing coal. Obviously, the regulation still works. They dropped our internal link that it says it leads to a bunch of energy efficiency technology, and they dropped the impact that it solves global energy use, and which is sufficient to solve global war, global warming and extinction. The other advantage. The military is key to resolve the majority of conflict and put a cap on it, which is our deterrence evidence, and it says it's key to resolve nuclear war. The FERC argument doesn't even say anything about microgrids. FERC isn't allowed to regulate emissions, which means that there isn't a price incentive to shift anything, which is why the app is key. The alt-cause evidence is about perception and isolation. It takes out the dis-ad more than it takes out the app, because it speaks of perceptions of other countries and things like protectionism, but it doesn't take out the affirmative, because military readiness is key to respond to any of those conflicts if they have. The counterpoint. Yep. They also concede that the app is key to prevent the rollback of all EPA programs, and an impact that says that a rollback of things like methane and other carbon programs lead to global warming and a variety of environmental impacts that lead to extinction. The counterpoint. Permutation to the app and the counterplan's ruling. The ruling is a disaster. It says that the federal government can't mandate any state participation in federal regimes, which makes all of the app impacts way worse because we specifically impacted federal programs vis-a-vis the environment. Federal, I'm not going to read that card. The multi-actor fiat is a voting issue. It's illogical and unrealistic, which proves irrelevant education advocacy skills. It's also unfair because it means that we can't win by defending our actor and defending the action. The net can always fiat every sovereignty deficit counterpropagation 50 state fiat sells all their offense. Conditionality for a sophistry over advocacy and strategy skew means the app never wins. CISPO ensures strategic control. Federal government is key to innovation because of state grant provision, which is something the app specifically sells in the counterplan deficit Rob 815. Observe that the same concerns drawn in mind by the pension to cling to the designs that watching the political innovation act of exemption under the right to the category. The government says it's true, the prompt has been law, and made it safe from the realm that safe pension programs will be hunting both out annual information states potentially expanding the federal government to for essential insight to the region we found the federal government has outspent by a substantial amount of states that show little inclination to assume this border measure by a region type, and now it's going to be a partnership to district circle to enter in the absence of federal engagement. And federal engagement devolution is a disaster across uncertainty that wrecks electricity markets rock 10-1. Increased federal jurisdiction and actually gives the state from flexibility to develop new regulatory schemes, predictability is important for any annual utilities. One of the proposed attempts to acceptable regulatory service of jurisdictional uncertainty of regulatory building uncertainty is a flip argument to risk market responsibility, but the fractionalization of our municipalization offer a way to gain the system of transmission order so allowed to appeal to local authorities of consistency. Our rules will be impossible in version of the interstate system, could result the abdicated federals, and that's the entire first advantage. Coercion challenges kill the federal state cooperative models now because it leads to politicized judicial disputes. There's no link to federals in the court, consistently opposed federal authority in this area. Advantage 10 instances of which courts involve all devaluation of legislation, fact that the industry completes against the province of state regulatory agencies in the court of concept. Legislation be within Congress. Authority the president seems to reflect a consistent determination that impacts electricity transmission, even if the direct impact of legislation is local and necessarily affects interstate commerce. Since market interstate commerce, the internal link to the net benefit is consistent with our model of federalism. The government says nationalization of water, but it's not about our model, even though the CPB is dictated by the federal government, still gives policymaking power to the states. The act is key to the WOTUS, rule, which solves our impact fissure in 15. The Clean Water Rules Fund doesn't almost certainly wind up before the Supreme Court. There's something unusual about the administration using agents who use wells or radically changes legal opinion about the federal statute means the EPA has used speaking territory dealing about a lot of water or other. The Supreme Court's inconsistency about a trumpet courts are generally supported to and are generally supposed to defer the judgment of regulators. That's marked that judgment of regulators. The IOT is keeping some global food security going on 15. Farming is the most important ingredient to civilization benefits for side farming, including higher yields, reducing crop failure, minimizing cost, while selling crops at high price, added sensibly available to them to view. This way, the more simple help make the best business decision about the measure. The need to take greater use of precision agricultural role, as it's making food stand, as food needs have an excess and population keep pace with the population, where food production needs to increase by at least 70%. Food shortage doesn't cause more illusion 11, and critical studies not support this argument, tech and capital increase, but it's making people increase as far as it's possible, and it's a sample for human security reports in the Middle East, foreign institutes. This way, we're going to have various extensive data based on the causes of water shortage, 80% chance of rolling into river, 2/3 full, and the water shortage, 7% water dry. Cooperation is part of cooperation politics. No impact outcome of climate from fortune during the initial stages of the crisis, multiple analysis throughout the crisis, we don't lead it with at least 6 months to use a partial repression of first reports on the rushing of a rate of the average data to just have a peaceful instance when he felt the same as was. Was the same as was in 2000, where recession has not triggered any increase in bond confidence, decline in bonds has been started with the end of the Cold War, has not been reversed. The CPP has given the economy out of the war, shown 16. The CPP drives immigration rates to adopt opportunities for investment for tools to help reduce emissions 28% by spending our economy by 25 billion choices up to 65 billion for more than the cost of compliance states are well over their way to comply and lay out now the way to comply and lay investments in renewable energy efficiency. Zero bringing economic benefits to climate, even more Pennsylvania generate 106 million in revenues could be invested in clean energy resistance. Cold work is a negative impact, not giving up a comfortable family undermining the U.S. economy. Tax reform does not solve growth. Summers of 17. Tax change, tax rate will redistribute income, increase uncertainty, place burdens on the same sectors of change, harm the global economy, will see by other countries protecting attack of violence, U.S. treaty obligations that will do damage to dollar debts and grow financial distress, American losses will be in the trillions, not the U.N., not it won't be a deal until spring if SACA sounds quitter in 2-2. Business owners are going to have to wait until later this year. Tax reform will be part of the spring of negotiation. Lots of months revealed the ACA must have the first biggest sticking point is a border tax controversy will make the GOP ban and Trump or the Lincoln's not meeting Sullivan in 2-2. There remains skepticism among Republicans about what Trump is doing. A little Congress has been consulted and paying political culture. Australia's the best of Republicans have shown little willingness to crowd on them to cross up and join forces with the Democrats. Court shield winning defied. We expect political support for judicial view of the contempt of judicial action officials like an expert counsel to shift decisions to judicial leader willing to go out and engage controversial citizens present tactically seek to overturn controversial questions of the courts to circumvent the legislature to avoid political flow with the right action shift in plan to the court may preserve electoral support fiat. Immediate to no run-up debate over climate logical policymaker could do both the app and pass tax reform. Political firestorms are inevitable and derails Trump's agenda ribbon 2-3. A later more temper frustration Trump did that this abuse and no this abuse most of the notion out of state sorts of purposes do not for the policy they found Republicans into a tailspin and in a case of trouble and Trump and legal and political parts are never on the case of checks and from accomplishing goals major initiatives or trying to hold Obamacare pills flagging this flagging the decline deadline has come and gone. We put on the real less than 50% Democrats have come up with on that and that have become much less to cooperate on that and that Democrats have become much less willing to cooperate the likewise effect from the House and the White House and the House have not agreed. They're no longer as long as the strikes on the more points will organize less likely the passive substantial reform the substantial reform becomes low approval proof that no political capital of margin is too small for the aftermath. The link is also backwards. It's about fighting environmental regulation, which is not what the AF does. Okay. The role of the ballot is to evaluate the enactment of the AF. The AF is not cruel optimistic attachment. Their role is not radical, and their reading of cruel optimism is way worse. Cornell and Ceiling 16. There's surely nothing cruel than to say that there is no way out of the horrific political exploitation of men's capitalism that leads the majority of the population conditions are dropping and target for extension bracing. The death threat for what amounts to the same thing abandoning oneself to the impending human UFO. Possibility of life is not such a big deal and certainly not natural fear of posthumous resistance to the environment. But recent theory that it's effectively tells in the name of posthumanism and everything must ultimately remain as if yet that the hope for different futures have a normative any idea of transforming that we have them transformed, transforming that we shouldn't have said. embrace the formality of extinction, and the death threat of these stories of profound power materialized made materials of one, of many, the interpreting for yourself is not to be that there's trust in the fiction itself, a form of liquid faith, and what, why I have faith that we are thoroughly affected there is a way for us to clear us outside of it, that's an identity deep from outside on the side of life, understood now in the outside of life itself, but as part of what the spirituality is struggling for different ways of living individually, collectively, without the beings with which we share the planet, face ecological risk, head on, rejecting productive, apocalyptic imagery, collapses into tacit denial as a little 213. The virtue of reaction is to make a choice order, then wish you watch your college without meeting such a challenge. There will only be operations that fail, but no plausible politics in nature. How I wish I could entertain you with using words about parts, but the I about the more dark of politics has to be done first. We have to determine what is the threat, which urgency politics to be adopted upon desires. We're good at framing themselves for something past what, when the time comes, it doesn't do localities to do. Never mind, we're taking themselves with you. We went to hide a great movement, just in order they never paid attention to society, or do the death to escape from the past, they seem. Now you've never questioned how to make such a new like astronauts make plans, dead out to space, with a tooth without an atmosphere, you suffocate with guys, trying to have force to render us, and the crime process, or anything, but not to deny politics, mediation, or. Have a positive talk. If all the talks of a guy about nothing seems to exploit the world, let's unite the dial of ontology or some neutralizing need, neither return to it, nor head nor a soil. It's only now that when the Jews are reinfilled, they realize how cozy was the preacher that's about to frighten them. The absurdity of life, the light, the happiness of those who enjoy those who can provide the apocure and tourist seated on the shore. This market seated on the shore, permutation to the affirmative and the alternative. They obviously linked to this too because they did representations like food scarcity. If the old sauce is utopian, that's a voter because it's a floating target and impossible for us to research militarism or any of the other stuff their impact evidence talks about can't be reduced to a single cause batch of its routine. Two imagine artists, an antidote to the military manifest as this medicine truth, palm origins of infatuation, power, anything but simple numbers without the invention of involved nursing fantasy, and power needs the size of the US as a whole to power a reveal of truth, neither will the will of God, but finality of false suffice to explain world war through militarism, with a byproduct of prior choices, and a system restoring balance will require a similar diplomatic approach.
Did you finish that
curve?
What's up? Did you finish that curve?
No, I marked it up. Pragmatic approach. Sorry.
Alright. Ready?
Yep.
The Cornell and Seeley evidence you read says that we should not do things like embrace the death drive, abandon oneself to one impending doom. I'm wondering why you think this answers the argument we've made. Like, where in the 1 and C did you say any of those things?
So the Scranton evidence is explicitly talking about the death drive, and it says that we should sacrifice ourselves in the face of capitalism.
I learned something new today. The Latour evidence says that we should engage the hard, dark job of politics to combat things like global warming. Where does it make a claim that like the state is key, or you know?
Well, so this is a defense.
It just says that like politics is good. What does politics?
Yeah, so I think this is a defense of kind of the rhetoric that we've used and kind of the investment we've made in resolving global warming. It says that investigating the political machinations behind that is important.
So what do you mean? What are the?
Sorry, one quick question. It's hard to hear in this room. Did you didn't read Alouche, right?
I did.
You did read? Okay.
Yes.
So when you say that we have to analyze like these underlying structures of politics, what does that mean? Like, what are the underlying structures?
Well, so we need to understand how politics operates. For example, vis-a-vis emissions, we want to investigate something.
What do you mean? How
like a major court case that either lets the government regulate emissions or not.
Okay. The Rave evidence you read is about, this is on the counterplan, is about federal grants being good. Why is this a warrant for why only like federal implementation is able to solve? It just seems to be talking about federal grants and like other programs that are
right. Well, so we've made an argument about the structure of federal programs. Your counterplan says that the federal government can't require states to comply with federal programs, which probably means that there wouldn't be any mechanism for them to receive grants from those federal programs anyway. The second thing is that in the context of the affirmative, federal funding to the states to implement their clean power plant requirements is important. The other issue is that we have a bunch of impacts that are about CAA programs that exist independently of the counterplan.
The Adams and Moscow evidence says that, is the CPP key to the economy argument? The only warrant I can identify is that warming is bad for the economy. How does the app solve
it? No, this says the CPP drives innovation and creates new job opportunities, which is based on the argument we made in the tech advantage.
What about innovation
about
what job opportunities? Why are
so our 1AC specifically impacted things like advanced manufacturing. This says it leads to innovation in the renewable energy sector as well.
Okay. Renewables. The Dresner evidence you read says that things like repression, diversionary wars, arms races, or a ratcheting up of great power conflict don't escalate. If that's true, then why is military, like what threats does military readiness prevent?
Well, so Dresner is specifically analyzing the recession and says that in that context, none of the conflicts escalated.
Yeah, but if those things don't escalate, then why are
Dresner is not making an argument.
Like what
Dresner
is it
not
that
making
institutions
argument, for example,
and
about like
checking.
Deterrence and military balance?
Yeah.
Is everyone good for the order? Alright, it will be politics, the counter plan, the tech advantage, the force advantage, and then the critique. Just the framework portion of the critique. Is everyone good?
I just got to move this out of my way. I don't know why I tried talking with the pen in my mouth. Yeah, that was
a lot. Okay.
It's okay. You try. Alright, now is everyone good?
Yeah.
Politics not going for it to see the drug pack, the economy don't have any advantage, they don't have any offense in the space, the low-pass counterplan, the competition, the competition, will to act if he has reason to reject the argument, on team conditionality, getting us in question, resist positionality, the whole time, and the very worst is dead, flexibility always in any of their offense, because they renew plant, new advantages, can see no impact of food wars, means they don't have any turns to the advantage, the tech advantage, they screwed up the first monster of P7, so it wasn't just a question of alternative causes, it's an offensive reason to reject the app, the act of surveillance only reifies violence state power in order to consolidate their economic monopoly over the world, think of Crush as the one AC, the app only gives more monetary incentive for people like Elon Musk, Stroke, etc. to continue to privatize and collect information to ensure total control of the pharmaceutical state, i.e. places like people like Marky, Stroke will just research new antibiotic-resistant drugs, but will just ratchet up their prices so that poor people cannot give them, which means that it makes a question of who dies in the pandemics of the affirmative world. Is it only the rich white people, or is it everyone in the world, which is a question that they have not answered. The Internet of Things permanently links them to all of this, because it's a question of massive data collection, which was also cross-sectively what I see in the instance of Internet policy. The perfect is the enemy of good. Their solution will ultimately fail as Mazarov 13 modern authoritarianism have been read. Freedom to expect that vague concept cannot help unseat the authoritarian regime sees. Not even how do we recognize the truth of subject to be authoritarianism not real or enjoyable to it. It's wicked of the solution proposed perfect the enemy of the good solution is pro. Impulse will survive excitement over the internet and latch onto ideology being ridiculed as you want to do something like subjecting politics lesson learned from the internet. We can try to rid ourselves of the internet censorship by making solutions seem harder to obtain, thus harder to implement them. Now, any case argument I win implicates the entirety of the critique because it proves that the representation of the affirmatives has details the entire research curriculum of debate. The only impact to your ballot is the education that we get from this round. If we win any one impact of the affirmative was violent, you should reject them because it was an imperfect scholarship and it gets imported on a global scale, particularly true in the age of Trump because we don't know what the fuck he is going to do on a larger scale, which means that we should be highly skeptical of anything the thing that they do. Now, rhetoric and pre-technical competition trades off a cooperation that is crucial to solve or provides cover and discourages it. It says, ice and 11, rather creating scorcher of the green tech, more nations can benefit from collaboration. This poses a major hurdle for tackling climate change. It must be surrounded for nations working on the planet. Is it powerful to not act together? Nationalistic rhetoric will have high cost continued. And tech is rigged about clean energy. Recently, make it difficult to conduct cooperative efforts in energy and environment. Matters advocating a strategy of competition under custody activities. Green tech warring makes it even more difficult to reach global climate agreement. Not even too much for senators who oppose international climate agreements to blame the Chinese. The rhetoric of green energy race can give cover for this regrettable posturing. This is particularly true because the people they give money to are people like Elon Musk, who are part of the Silicon Valley argument. Their piece of Mills evidence says, quote, they give monetary value to every square mile of silicon. This economic gesture proves that they only care about the richest people in the world who happen to be also alt-right activists on a large scale, which means that the people they give the tech to are only those who are rich and white, and those who are hurt and to the impacts of things like global warming, disease, etc. are people, poor people of color, which is also justified by our Scranton evidence. It indicates that the creation of outside threats to the economic order, i.e. as their tech evidence does, by saying, quote, we need to render the environment resilient, I imports the idea that the humanity is in always has an other that needs to be securitized against. Those securitizations are against people like Muslims, black people, etc., which is all proven by the current protests and different riots that are happening today. Status quo that needs to change the static order. The affirmative only upholds the neoliberal economic order that renders this violence possible. Now, the aspen optic militarization of green tech and cloud computing greases the wheel for extreme violence and surveillance. Soon, the NSA will appear as a public option in the ethical comparison. The Google caliphate, only the infusion of tech with ethics of demilitarization that solves this. Brighton 14, the seconds we have is the content of our daily communication now weaponized against the inverse panopticonic event is when you or know you are being watched and active. You are exhibitionism is a bad fake when considered versus the Google caliphate. The NSA may come to be more seen as the public option if we take 9/11 the wrong massive data gathering campaign. The entire network of communication for the last decade in our library, the real geophysical philosophical profile, the big hall of traditional politics and software, and the simulation is opaque and mappable. Another coherent totality be carved in the greatest blackness in the surface of the world that can no longer be composed in addition because it's so absolutely full, overridden, and overturned to add more than it's just ink to the ocean instead of tabula rasa. The tabula planus allows creativity and figuration, but only by subtraction, only scratching the paint from the caps, only by carving away by death, by replacing the content of one layer, could be replaced by a Kiseg hierarchy of fiction that ushered the uber new liberal. The stack is designed to be remade. We should be allowed for more comprehensive displays of beginning way for generally post-human and human position. The eclipse of the Anthropocene makes historical phase of Google gospel will give away those treatless platforms for multiple strata and make synthetic intelligence and bio communication settle into new continents of cyborg symbiosis. The one integral to essence, the second may be accidental trauma. These shifts also from the design community, the authors and anthropocene, the reporting role actors of last year may be black because we now see our own reflection. In acceleration, your block is the last esotropical with the chemical which grinding the base and the run of the isotope decay drawn by inhuman and human molecule from far flying now. The disease impact defense. Oh, if their example is really Ebola, why the medical system isn't working, that's obviously laughable because the medical system was able to effectively respond to disease issues in the status quo and prevent massive pandemics, especially because their evidence only suggests things like influenza increases, which obviously have never risen to the level of a pandemic, especially because there's much research in antibiotic system right now because scientists are so concerned about it. They don't have an internal link as why more data collection is necessary, which means there's only a risk of our offense, and they call to securitize against disease creates individual as a prison, which individual must now survey and discipline. The affusion of fear and catastrophic disease outbreak necessitates a capillary diffusion of carceral and biopolitical binds of debris and barter. And 9, Western states ask the population to preempt and take care of their health in context of ongoing pandemic. If disorder has to be the first level of securitization, the fear about the disease will be monitored. Consequently, one's bodies become the most vital disposers of continuing the pandemic of terror. The mandatory demands self-carceralization of fumble biopolitical self-terror bodies must be prepared in the midst themselves in the disciplinary mechanism bodies. Many regimes are biopolitical terror and a product of the governmentalized fear. Mark, that governmentalized fear now disease won't lead to extinction anyway. That's our Ridley evidence. There's multiple reasons. A, supporting his biology, they just evolved to death. Here's more evidence. Possible 5.1 recipients have managed to survive every disease of existence. There have been destructive plagues, but not become close to destroying the entire race. There's been biological reasons. Natural selection favors germs, lethality, because their genes are more likely to spread the leg. The odor of natural pandemic would cause extinction is less than despite wider conflict reasons. Medical science. B, supporting that status quo solves advanced medicines already exist in a status quo. Here's more evidence. Partner 13, the marine biotechnology has been applied to human disease. Does the products from marine origin marine events. Marine biotech is rapidly expanding. Scientists I have new methods to identify search for compounds and genetic materials that result in new products that cause yield life-saving medicines. C, supporting innovating actors and peers prove this war. That's more evidence. Here's that's Zakaria. 9, why do predictions turn out to be exactly what we can really anticipate the human response to crisis? The 24 was met by vigorous response to the epicenter. The mechanism reacted quickly, massively quantitating the infected population. The world we live in looks like nothing like 1918. Public health care systems are far better. Go to the next advantage. The first argument is that this status quo is able, or actually the first argument is that Trump is in all causes. This is not just a question of the perception argument about militarization, but rather Trump's grand strategy is to bomb the shit out of all of his enemies, which proves that military readiness is only a fuel to give him more power to be able to commit more violence in places like the Middle East and Asia, etc. Our evidence indicates that Trump is looking to fight proxy wars with Russia right now in places like Syria, because it shows that neo-military exceptionalism is going to be the key. The athlete makes that easier by increasing the surveillance, increasing the ability to deploy more troops, etc., which is able to solve the Yemen debacle that happened a few weeks ago, proves that we should not give our military any more credence under a Trump regime, because it just leads to the death of millions of more people. And independently, the 1AC accepts Western's common law understanding of itself, maintaining the dichotomy between law and disorder, which ushers in the perfection of necropolitical state capable of total lawfare under Trump. That's Kamarov and Kamarov in 7, hauled by before just history's made to submit the scales of justice behest of those who suffered imperialism and died before the creation of lawfare. Use the opinion holds to the administrative process of states of emergency to discipline accepted by mean of violence, made legible and legal by the sovereign world law for 3, maybe reduce people to bear life is mutated to necropolitics of rise and body counting seeks to launder its visceral power and a waste of law. Wash of legitimacy is a deployed strength that sinews of the state. The law and emergence of violence and live by violence means legal and lethal and admitted of one another. Mark at one another. Trump's grand strategy wrecks hedge and readiness proves he just goes to war. That's column 131. Trump has a strategy. Streams of erratic and improvisable ideas don't add to anything consistent beneath all the rants, tweets, and noise. There is a pattern of thought. Trumpian view. Trump has guided his administration for a policy riddled with dilemmas. Grand strategy architecture that leads to structure foreign policy leaders not handling global events. Strategy represents a head set of concepts about a country's goals, market goals, and military strength. Fails Trump's other policies, wreck its effectiveness. Also proves investment in cybersecurity always equals violence. As column 131, the prime pillar of Trump's strategy is a blue for militarism. Trump called for larger U.S. forces and significant new investment in cyber warfare capabilities. Trust bursts not to engage in adventures, but to deter the adversaries and defeat those who attack U.S. Trump pledged to intensify the campaign against the Islamic State, but consistently criticized both regime change and nation building. U.S. military's role is primarily to bomb the shit out of them. Trump's strategy diverges significantly from and intentionally subverts the bipartisan underpinning the U.S. foreign policy since World War II. Trump does not describe to American exceptionalism. Trump believes that America is a raw deal. He therefore is hostile to that order, institutionalized through alliances, and refuses to invest blood and treasure to maintain it, which means even if the international order is good as now, I will solve. They concede the analytical argument that Trump is going to roll back the CEA. He's already pledged through it, etc., to roll back every regulation that exists in the status quo, and for every new restriction added to their rollback, to which proves that the CPP won't be effective. And the former debate will just be in the one hour.
Okay, so the K-links on the first advantage are largely, or, you know, at least in good portion about structures of surveillance, the NSA, etc. What does being a philosopher do about any of that?
So our argument is that the judge makes an ethical decision between different models of education. We think that the philosopher who interrupts and refuses to engage in current forms of neoliberal governments, i.e. not advocating plans that just give more information to people like Elon Musk,
okay,
Martin Shkreli, etc., is a good idea and
right,
instantiates new understandings of
how do those new understandings
to
change something like NSA policy?
Because accepting the ability that you will die in the Anthropocene and accepting that there's mass violence going on in the status quo, one, prevents the otherization and scapegoating that exists
well,
in the
so
status quo.
I understand how
allows
that might
for new understandings of knowledge to arise, i.e. we start thinking outside of the current globalized
right
order that
so,
the state is
the
only way
so
to
the,
do
the
things.
Judges and us start thinking about stuff in a different way.
I mean,
how
this
does
will
that
obviously
to
be more in the
long
run. Our argument is that surveillance structures can only, or that policy can only be changed through affect. This will be a larger question than one.
Gotcha.
Obviously.
So you're just going to, like, change the affect of everyone who runs the NSA?
Well, we think that the only impact to the judge's ballot inevitably is not, like, implementation
right
or changing larger
okay
structures, but again, is educational.
So you have to go for it.
I mean, we would have to go for
it. Yeah, okay. That makes some sense. Let's talk about this green tech stuff. First of all, this author is someone who
writes about and supports U.S. energy regulation. Beside the point, this is about discourses of international renewable competition. Why do we have to do that?
I just agree. It's about capitalist competition regarding renewables and argues that when we bring renewables into the free market, it causes people to not care about the effectiveness of the technology to solve warming, but rather how much
profit they get out. Where do you think this says that?
It says...
This says antagonistic rhetoric about clean energy rates
make it difficult to conduct cooperative efforts in energy and environmental matters. Advocating a strategy of competition undercuts these activities. Green tech warming makes it more difficult to reach a global climate.
I'll ask something different. What about the AF was liberal legalism and lawfare?
The act of ruling on Chevron and arguing that
why
is good
Chevron
for military readiness, etc., is a form of liberal humanism that attaches ourselves to the law.
This card is about lawfare in the sense of, like, international war law, not
disagree.
Administrative
Karmarov is talking about the ability to rule on law and using law to control the world, i.e. I need to rule on the Chevron Doctrine,
so
etc. to get to military readiness is a problematic relationality to the world.
Okay. Got it. I guess the next thing I'll ask about is the, you know, disease argument. Is the link, I guess, aside, what card says that the disease resources would be distributed
incorrectly? Disease forces would be distributed incorrectly? That was just an analytical argument I made, and the Scranton evidence seems to suggest that that would be true.
It'll be the K.
As an act of scholarship, representations, epistemology, etc., are fair game. Sequence should be a question of evidence, not arbitrary theory interpretations. You should prefer this interpretation. Ace of Wayne's education, the act should be prepared to defend their scholarship critiques first debate over the process of creating policy, which is the most agreeable form of education. No scholar would be taken seriously if they couldn't justify their ideas. To be some point, they overlimit by arbitrarily excluding individual parts of the act. Scholarship, we need a diversity of response to the act to check biases and prep and strategies. Some point is that excluding critiques is bad. Gloss over key parts of the topic, at least ideological doctrines that makes valid activism impossible. The role of the balance to form an analysis of the assumptions behind security logic. It's the only way to create meaningful policy solutions that is a prior issue. To the planet, worst framework is a reason why we should be able to weigh their impacts. They should be able to weigh their impacts, so they still get the K. Their state-centric approach sacrifices the agency and causes violent chafer. And 7, identifying the same we choose division, hence we conform our behavior to the purposes of such entities. Our lives become institutionalized parts of the machine. The idea that we are the government makes these political officials generate wars across the reinforced attachment for the state. When our ideas become wrapped up with the state, our loss of control over our lives, our efforts to pursue purposes that become central to us, we engage in violence, projecting traits on others and punishing them for our own shortcomings. You should err negative. We have the only framework with any political potential. We have the more coherent explanation of how politics functions. You can vote negative on presumption. The affirmative is like Hillary's carbon tax proposal or concession speech. It's great in theory, but couldn't get anyone on board because they couldn't have affectively mobilized Herringer and Mueller. In 16, we need to leave the certainty of science and carbon budget behind. Trump's discourse resonated on an affect of all the people led more by passion than reason. Recreate a politics that makes people feel more a part of this, appealing enough to fight the juggernaut. We need less COP23 and more ending a lot less doomed fights for carbon taxes and more effective struggles. Which means more disobedience and less time in the political halls of climate politics remain tied to treason. And truth, the reason and truth will necessarily fail. Only in climate politics that it sees the affect of attractiveness can win the fights that we need to win. For the Cornell and Seeley evidence, there's no link to it. Our argument is not that we should embrace the death drive or accept that we are all fucked. It's just that the fear of destruction of environment gets translated into destruction of neoliberalism, which causes a permanent maintenance of the system, which is something that 2NC was pretty good on. This is especially true in the age of global warming and Trump, which is two reasons why information is uniquely persuasive, which is, I don't think, an argument that that the two AC comes to grips is we are inundated with information about warming and the effects of it. We have been since an inconvenient truth, but there is a literal negative correlation between scientific consensus and public consensus and action on these things, which proves that political solutions can never actually solve. And a reason why only Africa is key. Second is that the evidence I just read indicates that Trump was only able to be elected not because he initiated specific policy proposals, because he engaged affective resonances that were effective with certain segments of the population, which is a reason that only our counter resonances, which I'll explain on the alternative debate, are able to solve that, which is a reason that the app literally doesn't solve anything independently. The 2AC dropped the value life impact. You shouldn't let them get new answers to this, because we predicated our block strategy based on this concession. This grand evidence indicates that the fear of environmental destruction that gets translated into a fear of neoliberalism makes us cogs in the collective machine that sustains the system, and we cannot which obviates any value of life, which means that extinction is not a unique impact. The Latour evidence, we are not climate denialism. We are an alternative strategy to solve these issues, which I've explained already. Their argument is that we have to, or at least in cross-ex, is that we have to understand underlying structures and like politics as to why neoliberalism and climate change and things like that happen in the first place. We have to, that's probably a warrant for why our evidence is true, because we have to understand how fear-driven capitalism makes no other strategies imaginable. Now the permutation links still links, because it includes the action of a plan. The 2NC was pretty heavy on case-specific links, but I'll do a couple more here. The first of all is the CPP link. The reformism of the CPP locks in capitalism and causes extinction. Only a radical departure from reformism can solve. Kutcher 15. CPP is not enough. Limited measures driven by reform sensibility. Avoiding more radical approaches to climate change. You take the liberty to decide how to meet the goal. 32% reduction is not an across-the-board cut for each power planner each day. That is the anticipated reduction result if each day meets the EPA determined goal. Lurking deeper is the act of existential denial. Our collective inability to confront the truth. Capitalism meets them to the greater of the planetary ecosystem. Obama's plan for the rebels is continued embrace of capitalism. CPP appears ignorant of the laws of their dynamics. They teach that in a finite ecosystem rule set. They use the premise of an infinite growth rules on catastrophic collapse. Obama can't have the EPA abolish capitalism. Reform only brings us closer to civilizational collapse. The second link is mea culpa. The app is Trump's climate policy. Mea culpa, which takes the wind out of radical movement sails and makes meaningful action on warming impossible by locking in purely adaptive strategies. Externally, this spirals into a geoengineering bonanza, which causes extinction. Read in 16. In 2017, Trump allowed climate movement tells that now he gets to be prepared for a huge type of relief. Perhaps we still have a chance. The process has already begun. Trump has pulled back from his previous denialism. Trump's acceptance of climate reality. He tried to take the wind out of the sails of a remarkable number of his opponents. Too many of the intelligentsia will be rushed with relief toward the conclusion that Trump can be normalized, and we are actually on the brink of a fascist endgame. Cronies will continue to eviscerate regulation, back big business, and burn fossil fuels, and encourage to places. See, there is a danger that Trump, who gets it on climate, may seem not worth the trouble of opposing their significant elements of the right that favor survival strategy vis-a-vis adaptation. The scariest possibility involves that a climate wake up could take him in the direction of geoengineering and total planetary management. Fits well with the hubris, technology, utopianism, and refusal to change of the right, what bolder idea for Trump than to tackle in the biggest way by taking charge of the climate and finding a solution that will let us keep the petrol flowing in the oceans dying. When Trump's climate moment comes, we need to be ready to push back. Otherwise, it might lead us into the fire of an out-of-control tech-obsessed future in which climate reality becomes an excuse for allowing the world's biggest polluters to take ownership of the atmosphere as well. They say that our representations link. They concede the thesis of dispositionality, which means we get to kick arguments as logic, or which means we get to logically kick arguments. Our interpretation is negation theory. The role of the negative is to disprove what the 1AC did was a good idea. They have infinite prep, so they should be prepared to defend against all of their assumptions. At worst, the disads were examples of why the system, at least the disads were examples of why the system backfires, which means there's not a unique link. The alt-utopian debate, it's not the alternative, is to adopt a position of a philosopher who says no to the app by rejecting resonance of fear. You should use the ballot to express political dissent beyond the grasp of neolization's regulatory framework. This grand evidence indicates that we have to connect to affect that exists in the status quo that flows power, which is also a reason the affirmative does not solve, because they do not create the affective connections that are necessary to mobilize large segments of the population.
Thank you.
More like people that interpret probability to be certainty and chills. That's what I think.
Yeah. You don't really need to read that one. Just read the 18.
You're trying to quantify events.
Yeah, read that
one. Okay. Yeah. Your life, you can really
no,
read
I think
thing.
I should read
that. Okay.
So I was talking about that, like, the TGS asked, like, you know, what do you think about Trump? I was like, yeah, I don't know, political science. So, like, I was just like, why would you say that?
These are bad, right?
Yeah, I was like, if they're going to cut anyone, it's obviously going to be you now. You just said you tell me.
I don't think
so
that's
super easy. Why would you say that?
Just take that legalism.
Yeah, I can say
is
that.
Is
that
really because you're positively institutional in sense?
Yeah, I mean, and, like, he was the same guy that I like, had like, talked to Ramirez with two people, and he was the same guy. And then we asked him, he's like, you know, what do you think political science can even do? Like, what does it matter that we do anything? And then she was just like, well, I mean, like, Trump isn't forever. There's other levels of government. It's comparatively better than whatever you want to do. Plus, likely complementary to it because it provides the requisite information. And he was just like, I don't know.
I was like, why are you
we're going to be doing
it's like, what are you I mean, like, I have sympathies for the argument, but it's also just, like, poor timing. why would you say this now? He was like, if they don't make, like, no one makes policy based on, you know, like,
can you say
that?
Yes.
Be able to do it, you know? Yeah. He's a little, a little bit, yeah.
Thank you.
Yep.
The tech advantage, the port advantage, decay. Are you prepared? Yeah, that's what you're two internal links. First is energy efficiency. Second is the turnaround of the entire CAA. It only strengthens the neoliberal state and precludes the possibility of any alternative because it causes slow violence. Even if our process is imperfect, the alt forecloses any material improvements of the status quo and guarantees total extinction, which we can't come back from. Their survivalism links are an inevitable part of the state. The question is whether or not the market has the potential to improve. Our argument isn't that the internet is always perfect or that we should depend on it for every form of technology, but it's coming. Companies will rely on it. It's a question
question of its utility. The alt says, let's ignore the facts that companies are making use of the internet now. They use it for things like surveillance, the NSA, etc., and screw over people who are impacted by its worst consequences and ignore the possibility for reform. You shouldn't reject us for one link. A is that's a bad form of scholarship, which will be the framework's made, but it means we never get to weigh the rest of the F, which proves that we always have to reach an unattainable form of perfection. But B is, if this is true, you should vote F now, because it links to all of their own 1 and C arguments about how we should do things like not pass policies so that the Republicans can have unity and can get some tax reform that perfects certain parts of the economy. Or F is it the green tech hegemony that their eyes evidence is about? There's no evidence about the rich white activist rant that she goes on it. The alternative to green tech is just endless consumption of coal, which is outlined by all our electricity evidence and turns all of their offense. The alternative isn't securitization of the other. There's no argument tied to a 1AC impact. Even if securitization is a thing that exists in the vacuum, their broadside evidence is NSA bad, which is the status quo, not the gap. The uniqueness claim is that antibiotic resistance fails without health system. There's no evidence about the internet or the case. The reps case and the thing. Fowler and 14, the impact of completing about here would be enormous. The benefit of receiving alarms to people enables us to adaptation strategies. It enables us to access the true cost of antibiotic resistance and to end inquisitive polarization mitigation strategy. Of course, these processes take time. The alarm has been raised, and there's clear evidence of response within systems nationally and globally. Rejecting fear is Bush Williams, 11 to fear completely with analytically. There's a little bit by day. Transition Friday, U.S. view of the fear, the absence of fear could be dangerous as overabundance. Disregard the others, result of vanity, could lead to the world to have a place to certain results of democracy in the name of universal truth. And recognizing these dangerous beliefs acts as a positive concern on human accesses. Marked accesses, burnout is wrong. Carter and 14 has been hypothesized that there is an upper limit to the virtual succession of all pathogens. Is a pathogen that kills its host, but not have enough time to spend new ones. If the model predicted virtuals are not linked that way, pathogens in the law of high levels of virtuals can evolve. Marked and evolved. The medication can't spread without the app, and interventions doesn't work without data, but their evidence proves their key. The court's advantage is no evidence about all of these Trump claims. The app only increases the risk of a transition conflict, or rather that the alts does. Our argument isn't that we give Trump more power, but that we prevent a violent transition away from the places we're already committed. There's no lash out. The idea 11 is most likely that Trump would be careful to deploy the larger large terms given to you. Less social tendencies sound clear, but the Trump would be capable of working with Congress to fund large and military operations. Marking these events have operations. Norms don't create war. Lumen intention has nothing to say about the constructive status of politics. It's stereotypes of enemies, not friends. Political meetings debates each other trivial. It's hard to see the moral combat. It's a remote possibility. The critiques of lawfare and chancellor from the law are not the same thing as the end to all war. Humanitarian military intervention. So switch warning does not apply. Marked and applied. Trump can't under force or roll back our regulations. Hard being 16. They just can't do it with the way they want. It's able to apply. The new administration have to change the rule. After it's been upheld before, the rule is not law. It's not as if the EPA can say never mind that in itself would inevitably be litigated. The bottom line is that a risk that Trump does one bad thing doesn't mean we shouldn't attempt to improve the status quo. Now, the K. First, the impact debate. The year impact is worse. Fast and intent. The survival only shifts the lines. Too hard to get to my ultimate level. It's also the limits of reflection and actions. Instead, lost some of its sharpness and binary reduction of life in their life. They qualify revenue, racism, the complexity, riches, fuck, and normative prejudice when generalized to underprivileged collection of facts. I have deprived the agents of voice and action. This versus scholarly and political biographies suggest the necessity of complicated and dualistic models. Powers like the marketing to do that. Some of the beings could be reduced to real life by forces from within the church of power. Produce alternative churches and escape the destruction of people themselves. Manage shovel tactics that transform their life into an instrument of moral resource or effective explanation, which proves that value to life isn't absolute. It can be transformed, and we should preserve individual choice. Evaluate the 1AC. FLNC matters. Justification for security assumptions as the role of the battle is arbitrary. For flashy education, broad policy issues are good. They create knowledge and skills to challenge contingent and structural problems. And equitable debate necessitates FLNC. Otherwise, you arbitrarily obviate large portions of the case. Folding things are voting issue. They steal the 1AC, make them contradictory assholes, and all of alternative solvency arguments apply. It proves the perm we solve. Education limits and including critiques. They just have to be weighed against the app. There's no link to Schaefer because we don't have to identify with the state to talk about the state. Their framework is not political, and you can't vote neg on presumption. The app is just an imperfect political candidate. The alt is a way worse version of everything Will Morgan has ever said, which is 1,000 times less politically potentialized or skill relevant to any skill set. Trump's affect is only the reason we need normal knowledge against warming. The scenario planning is good. Barman 15 hours diagnose the gap in academia and policy. We enhance communication with the whole component, bridging the gap in the crucial component is attending regions that are actually involved in the challenges are acute. Christian struggling a little. His page techniques, particularly policy ideas, the outlines of the problem is approach developing research program. The scenario analysis is focused on pedagogical benefits of this technique. And scenario analysis in the surveys, court planning, this is not limited to these uses. Marked the piece of evidence is limited to these uses. The permutation, it operates in two ways. One, imagination of the alt isn't incompatible with the app because it's an individual strategy. Two, the alternative can overcome the links. The CCP link is just that it's not enough. Not that it's bad. Representations alone don't shape reality because they can't dictate material action. There's no trade-off between the app and alternative Trump movements. One, no evidence says that he will already have a climate moment regardless of the app. No link to geoengineering related to the case. The impact is about dirty coal, which the status quo makes worse, and it won't happen. McDonald's will take you there. Or any number of why the proposition never seems to get any traction. Users are too expensive. There's legal complications for offering them. I can take a geoengineering. It will never be a panacea, and we're not ready. The alt does nothing. Their political strategy is terrible. They say warming and say, fuck it, we can't do anything. They sit between coal plants and say, screw it, let's be a philosopher. Understanding how fear-driven capitalism some dust to think its world was. It's a fun FYI, but it can't do shit. That's our two. I see evidence. Exclusive causal focus and affect is a theoretical shortcut. That's shit. Grossberg intent affect. Can it let it off the hook against the surface of the mental turn? There's not a lot of theorizing that doesn't know how to work. Testing my knowledge or apparatus or analyzing after push through non-cultural and empirical lazy. Not so much of a vision of pure radical. That doesn't mean there is a structure of people out. There's never been a turn that might be possibly an explanation to the shape of ontology. That's a reason to radically teach girls in politics. Most people's work to be looking so fast to be off. That's not a lot of anything to make the way for the body.
Can we get a mark,
though?
Yeah. I'll send it off.
Yeah, I'll start prepping.
Mm-hmm.
You can also look this, I guess I'll look this also as well.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So it will be the critique, the tech flow, the course flow. Is everyone good to go?
We decided to go for the cake and block because the choice fucked up by answering a bunch of their arguments, which means all they do arguments in their way on sheet. You should be highly skeptical of or just strike out their flow. Here are the things that they get in the 1 hour that were answered in the choice. First, they get to answer disease rep because that was a new argument made. Second, they get to answer to liberals. And third, they get to answer to geoengineering. All the rest of the 1 hour argument should have been in the 2AC. The fact that they weren't doesn't mean that Natalie just gets to make up for it because she's super fast. You should hold the line on these arguments because the blocked in was based off 2AC concessions. Now, they forever debate. They conceded the only impact to your ballot is that of education. The only thing that you can implicate the research correction of debate, which means if our linked arguments are true, you should not weigh the implementation of the app versus the representation, because if they do not justify their scholarship in the first place, then it begs the question of what the fuck are they doing in debate if education doesn't matter, especially because we cannot actualize policy on a larger scale, which means that it begs the question of what is useful about their state-based education, which means that at the very worst, the only impact to the affirmative at the end of the day is their Cornell and see the arguments and their scenario planning good arguments, which are due not yet to answer the threshold of affect. I'll do that here. Our argument is that affect is the only way that can stretch politics in the status quo. Our evidence is the only piece of evidence that speaks to the Trump administration and how politics functions in the status quo, which means that none of their evidence rings, which means scenario planning, etc., are all useless in the current political world we live in because no one cares about facts anymore. It's just a question of tweets, resonances, etc., which is able to solve this scranton ever. It makes a comparative claim and argues that taking the position of the philosopher that interrupts the research curriculum of things like the affirmative is able to solve on a larger scale because it opens up new ways of relating to the world, i.e. we have new affective resonances where we argue that activism is not only tied to mobilization on a material level, but the way in which we think about the world and the ways and scholarships that we enact. And if we win the securitization logic is bad, we shouldn't have to win a large alternative solvency claim because they just create more violence in the world, which is enough of a reason to reject the affirmative because the only negative burden is to disprove that the app was a good idea. The very worst, if you do weigh their implementation, all the security breaks still access all of their access a large portion of their impacts and implicate their solvency claims, which is something they have not answered. Now they say our impact is worth the fast and evidence should be rejected because the value of life argument was just flat dropped in the 2AC. At the very worst, our argument is that value to life is structured by the very idea of how we determine what survivalism is. The 1AC determines survivalism as being important insofar as that humans are only important as long as they defer to the markets in the first place. Our argument is that destroys value to life because it means that our lives are only so valuable as the market determines them, instead of having a self-discovering of how our own value, which is being internally turned their class in argument, which is just about self-discovery of value. The floating picks argument, we weren't a floating pick. We don't have any part of the affirmative in the alternative, which means that it's not a voting issue. At the very worst, we argue that new political strategies, absent not something like the affirmative, can occur in the world of new affect. The link to be our, they say that only to Schaffer. Schaffer evidence indicates that by arguing that the state is the only way to solve things like climate change, etc., is a violent form of relationality because it denies the possibility for individuals to take action and takes the air out of radical movements. Things like the Zapatistas, Occupy, the Women's March, etc., are all riots, are all protests happening in the status quo that have effective political power because they effectively resonate with large portions of the country and are actually changing policy. The bans on things like Standing Rock for a while were due to affective resonance. The reason that Trump was able to undo those things is because there was taken out of those protesting movements because we just say, well, Trump's president, so we might as well normalize it, which means that their normalization is not just that they are a bad politician, but they are a politician that allows Trump and authoritarianism to continue on a larger scale. Only the alternative deals on a larger scale to that, which means that they don't solve the permutation. Still obviously links to the entirety of the critique because it includes the 1AC. They have the alternative is not just an individual strategy, but a larger political question of research paradigms, etc., which was all done above, which means that the permutation doesn't make sense. The most of the link will be done on the case debate that Trump's union engineering. argument, I'll send the mea culpa argument here. The Reid Evans makes a predicted claim based on political pressures that Trump will have the momentum when he gets it on climate. This is true because he's an economic and technocratic incentive to do things like geoengineering to preserve fascist domination over world, which they concede it fails and causes extinction because it destroys the environment and does things like iron fertilization, which destroys biodiversity. And you'll check several arguments that there are movements now that are counterizing the Trump policies, like the app Take the Wind, out of those movements. Their only piece of evidence they have on this question just says that geoengineering isn't online yet. Our argument is that Trump brings it online because of the innovation the app gives him, makes it more possible to solve. Their last argument is that politics shouldn't are structured by ontology. That's not our argument. Go to the tech debate. First link is the law debate. This is both a link to their rhetoric and their advantage. It's a fiat double bind and a link to their framework. Just as they fear the lack of law in the world, they fear a lack of law in the debate. They attempt to police this in round with their framework arguments. Their performance creates a genocide on colonialist curriculum. Anything and everything becomes worthy of extermination in favor of law. Think of the tag of their Busby evidence in the 1AC. They fear quote-unquote ambiguities and indeterminacies in environmental law that might result in lost heads. It's the same logic you've been used by people like Trump and Pence to create anti-LGBTQ laws and the travel ban. That's our Comaroff evidence. The next argument is that I stand up as any case that arguing that competition should exist in things like green tech, etc., destroys the cooperative effort necessary to solve things like warming because companies don't give a shit about resources, etc. They all are polluting poor communities. They care about making enough profits, which means that their renewables, etc., will just replace the bad coal that Natalie goes on a rant about it back, which means they're not able to solve the CPP advantage. Our argument about Trump is not answered by any of their evidence. Our evidence indicates that Trump's grand strategy of military is to quote-unquote bomb the shit out of our enemies, which none of their evidence rises to the threshold of speaking to. Even if he's an isolationist, he still cares enough about military prestige and his own image that he will just use the new military readiness that the AF gives him to do things like bomb the Middle East, etc., which means even if the intention behind their AF is to get rid of interventions in the Middle East, that's bad. It also has a cybersecurity claim and argues that more cybersecurity just allows Trump to hack into our emails and do bad things like that, create new privacy laws, bans, etc., that hurt people like Muslims and Mexicans.
I actually think this Gaddy card is good. Trump can't fund.
Yeah.
My computer just started not marking for some reason. Actually, never mind. I didn't mark this card. That was how I think about it.
Okay. Yeah. Because I had you marking one card,
yeah,
but it was not
Comrade.
It
was Ison. Yeah.
Okay.
Thank you, though.
John, you're such an active judge.
I always think that I should do that, but it's just too lazy. So much effort.
My problem is, like, I don't know how to use the mark function, so if it's, like, if it's, so for the 1 hour, I just don't open a speech chat. Like, I just don't do read mode, because I can just enter, enter, enter. But the 1AC, I feel like I go faster in read mode, and so I just can't mark 1AC cards. In this debate, I marked one, and I had to go back after and mark
the
exact same route to enter.
The thing doesn't work.
My marking just stopped.
Oh, no, I just don't. Yeah. I've just never learned. Like, I have no excuse.
Oh, okay.
I
always made Theo do it. I didn't know how to.
Nothing.
Okay. Right. The tech advantage. Ports advantage. Okay. Are we good? Okay. The impact of the app outweighs a small chance that a new scholastic orientation table to fundamentally move us away from all neoliberal climatology framing issues. They've conceded that the political strategy provided by the 1EC is able to solve environmental destruction and global warming. That outweighs a lead to effects across the globe that culminate in extinction and reinforces resource disparities that cause increased extraction. The magnitude outweighs all their structural violence impacts, prove that they have some stake in trying to make the world better, which means that the horizon of extinction is prior to that possibility. Second, with that, it turns the KDF internal links to extreme resource utilization, which is the root cause of fossil fuel political lobbying power. The effects of climate change lead to structural environmental violence, which turns their value to life impact. They have the value to life impact. Even if they win a scholarship framework, you should probably urge towards the research agenda that has the best chance of solving extinction, given that they've conceded the entire solvency chain of the advantage. The second thing that they've conceded is that the IoT is able to solve disease, whereas they conceded a card that said that representations of apocalyptic disease are key to research analysis, which means it's uniquely important to engage in that type of scholarship. They also conceded a card that entire repression of fear just leads to lash out because people aren't able to manage it, and upfront recognition is better. The arguments on the case, I think, the extent of the lawfare came here, but if that'll enter it. Anyway, the app was not about lawfare. Their impact is about war law. Our thing, our advantage was about military readiness, administrative law, and Chevron cannot control the entire world because that is fucking ridiculous. Sir Lubin Evans says that there are ways to resist lawfare from the inside and impose constraints on the use of war, which is another reason why our scholarship is good. The other thing, the extent is about the profit motive. But if companies are only motivated by profit, then changing that profit motive is obviously the only way to solve the critique. So implementing something like a cap and trade system would be the only way to solve. They don't have any renewables back. Kurt Ison just says that the global renewable competition is bad, which is not something the app talked about. Court's advantage. The app is able to solve military readiness. The entire case demonstrates that a move away from the military and constraints on it leads to violent breakdown, which is something that was conceded as for the military argument. Their only argument is that Trump would also lash out at people. However, this is a reason why trying to engage with the military and make sure that we're able to put a cap on deterrent conflict, which is something that they also conceded the theory to, is very important. We've read a card that says Trump's grand strategy is one of isolationism. The specific warrant for that was that he's not able to fund any of these major latch-out arguments, which means that their impact thing doesn't take out the affirmative. However, the app is a reason why we are key to solve the type of global lash-out that all their stuff talks about. Okay.
The vast majority of the KR events are about the stats going down each of those things and using them as an a priori reason to reject them when he sees the worst model of engagement because it takes one piece of scholarship and makes it impossible to defend, which is our half-relevancy argument. You should explicitly consider the one he sees in its effects rather than just letting it get bogged down with a bunch of ethical normative statements. Have a very high threshold for voting on any of the link arguments or frame. First, if the debate is about affect and scholarship, then they link because of the politics it's at and federal dumb. They secured stuff. They said Trump economic policy was good. If they don't link approves the permutation, and if they do, then this whole thing is a non-starter. They never made an argument about perf-con theory, and their framework argument is about evaluating speech acts and scholarship, though obviously they fucking link to normalizing Trump. Second is that each link is about larger structures, that the app, that ask, does the app meaningfully change that just because of enunciating the 1AC or its politics, and if so, does the alternative change anything? The explanation for it is incredibly vague. They just say that there are movements, but the alternative is explicitly not movement-based. It is scholarship. It's not organizing, which means that our framework argument about challenging certain political logics is a better internal link to that. Now, the debate proper, new arguments. There was a one-card K that proliferated arguments in the blog, which justified all of our answers of the new links and our answer to the new framework argument because you only read an affect card in the blog. The value of life argument was a case outweighs on the case outweighs card. I'll do the education, I'll do the framework debate here. We think that the plan should matter. App relevancy is very important. It is important because throwing out the affirmative makes there be a disincentive for the app to do research and scholarship at all, which means that it leads to a larger propagation of these things. The app is able to produce something. They've largely conceded the thesis of scenario planning that says that policy relevant research agendas are able to export that through certain linkages to policymakers and make them change the way that their policy and then make them change the way that their policies operate, which is a better linkage to changing any sort of macro political structure that's able to solve any of the impacts that they do. They never indict that theory. They only talk about affect. Affect is bad. To win that, it matters. They need to win that their affect is able to challenge Trump, which is something that they have not proved. The one-year card in affect is very good. It says that it's not, and that says that affect theory is largely too vague and is kind of used as a catch-all for a bunch of them, for a bunch of things that we're not actually able to match causally or with scholarship, which proves that their framework is actually anti-educational because it's impossible to figure out affect of causal mechanisms because it changes based on context and every single person, which means that their framework argument and alternative is based on a fundamentally unfalsifiable assumption. Simply saying security is bad, it does not mean that they have good scholarship. It needs to be materially produced, i.e. how does the scholarship affect politics? We've won that our scholarship nexus of scholarship and politics is able to solve extinction. Value to life. The internal link to this is the entirety of the neoliberal economic system, which isn't something that they're able to change. Market logic doesn't determine all life. That's an arbitrary determination. Ignores inevitable resistance to the market that happens anyway, which means that they can't win global flattening. The argument in the app probably outweighs the neg was not the Zapatistas that was long. The neg was not the Zapatistas that was largely above the normalization debate. Trump, you can still say Trump policy is the Trump policy is bad. And they link to them. They link to this as well. The final two arguments I'm going to go for are one, a permutation that says you can do the affirmative and their framework argument, which proves obviously if they're able to use multiple different forms of affect in a speech act, then we should be able to also. And if their new scholastic agenda is enough to overcome all of this bad stuff, then it should probably solve the final argument they have. This Trump link, it doesn't describe the app. It's about Trump climate policy. That would be a facade for not actually reducing emissions. Instead of proffering something like geoengineering, this is his status quo approach to environmental policy. The app is decidedly anti-fossil fuel, which disproves their corporate capitulation arguments. The neg disproves the Trump link. Their DA, because there is that. This also proves why it's necessary to engage in the details of potential policies, because clearly some Trump politics is inevitable. Their approach would lead to a summary denouncement rather than lobbying for something less destructive. The only impact of this was geoengineering, and he dropped the card that said it's not even possible anyway.